Hello dear class, in the previous classes we have discussed the story Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory from chapter 4. Let's have a glance on the story. So in the previous class what we have discussed is every Monday on his way back from home Bipin Chaudhary would drop in at Kali Charan's in New Market to buy books. Okay, he used to buy the crime stories, ghost stories and thrillers. He had to buy at least 5 at a time to last him through the week. Okay, so he need to complete all these stories within a week at least 5 times. In sense, 5 books at a time. So he lived alone. He was not a good mixer. Had few friends and didn't like spending time in idle chat. Okay. And one day at Kali Charan's, okay, Bipin Babu had the feeling that someone was observing him from the close quarters. Okay. As you can see in the picture that someone is watching him or observing him closely. And he started having conversation with this strange boy. Okay. He turned round and found himself looking at the round faced meek looking man who now broke into a smile. Okay. The strange man observing says that I don't suppose you recognize me. And Bipin Babu says, have we met before? So they have a conversation here. We met every day for a whole week. I arranged for a car to take you to Hudro Falls in 1958. In Ranchi, my name's Parimal Ghosh. Now Bipin Babu realized that it was not he but this man who was making a mistake. Bipin Babu had never been to Ranchi. He had been at the point of going several times but never made it. So he asks, do you know who I am? And the strange person says, do I know you? Who doesn't know Bipin Chaudhary? Okay. Still, you are making a mistake. One often does. I have never been to Ranchi. So, he says that I have never been to Ranchi. You have been mistaken me. Okay. Then, the strange person says, what are you saying, Mr. Chaudhary? You had a fall in Hudro and cut your right knee. I brought you iodine. I had fixed up a car for you to go to Netherhat. The next day, but you couldn't because of the pain in the knee. Okay, this is what the story and the conversation that had been taken place between them. So now we'll start with the new paragraph from today. Very strange. One evening I had tea with you in a veranda of your bungalow. You spoke about your family. You said you had no children and that you had lost your wife 10 years ago. Your only brother had died insane, which is why you didn't want to visit the mental hospital in Ranchi. Okay. So what does the strange person say? The man goes on to mention how unusual this is because he even remembered having tea with Bipin Babu in the veranda of his bungalow in Ranchi, where he told him about his family. The man gives complete details about Bipin Babu's family and tells him that he had no children. He even adds that Bipin Babu told him that he lost his wife 10 years ago and his only brother died in a mental hospital in Ranchi, which is why he he did not want to visit the mental hospital in Ranchi. Okay, so the strange person says it. Okay, and the strange person name is Parimal Ghose. Have you remembered it? Okay, fine. We'll move on. When Bipin Babu had paid for the books and was leaving the shop, the man was still looking at him in utter disbelief. Okay? Utter disbelief means complete surprise. Surprisingly to see. Bipin Babu paid for his books and moved on his way out of the shop without saying anything. Meanwhile, the man looked at him in bewilderment. Okay, so this is what happened. Bipin Babu's car was safely parked in Bertram Street by the Lighthouse Cinema. He told the driver as he got into the car, "Just drive by the Ganga, will you, Sitaram?" Driving up the Strand Road, Bipin Babu regretted having paid so much attention to the intruder. He had never been to Ranchi, no question about it. It was inconceivable that he should forget such an incident which took place only 6 or 7 years ago. He had an excellent memory, unless Bipin Babu's head reeled. Okay? So, here intruder means person who intrudes or observes. Inconvincible means not capable of being convincible. Imaginism or grasped mentally means unbelievable. Head reeled means he was shocked and very confused. So what happened here? Bipin Babu went towards his car that was parked in Bertram Street nearby Lighthouse Cinema. Okay. His car was parked in Bertram Street nearby Lighthouse Cinema. As he sat in the car, he told his driver Sitaram. So the name of Sitaram is, sorry, the name of driver is Sitaram here. He told his driver Sitaram to drive by the Ganga. While the driver drove up the Strand Road, Bipin Babu felt immense regret at having given so much importance to the man. Okay. He knew he had never been to Ranchi and he was sure about it. He knew it was impossible for him to forget about such an important time of his life, and that too not from very long ago. It was only a period of 6 to 7 years, and regardless, he had no doubts related to his flawless memory unless his head was shocked or confused. Okay. Moving to next paragraph. Was he losing his mind? But how could that be? He was working daily in his office. It was a big firm and he was doing a responsible job. He was not aware of anything ever going seriously wrong. Only today he spoke for half an hour at an important meeting. And yet the man knew a great deal about him. How? He even seemed to know how intimate details. The bag of books, wife's death, brother's insanity. The only mistake was about his having gone to Ranchi. Not a mistake, a deliberate lie. In 58, during the pujas, he was in Kanpur at his friend Haridas Bakhchi's place. All Bipin Babu had to do was write to know. There was no way of writing to Haridas. Bipin Babu suddenly remembered that Haridas had left with his wife for Japan some weeks ago, and he didn't have his address. Okay? So what happened here? will it be apt to say that Bipin Babu was losing his mind? So what happened here? Bipin Babu was regretting that he has given much importance to the strange person. It was quite impossible to believe because he worked at a big firm and he worked daily. He had a responsible job. Even if there was something not right, he never realized that there was something major going on with him. That particular day, he spoke for a stretch of only half an hour at a very important meeting. But it is also true that the man knew quite a lot about Bipin Chaudhary, and that too some very personal details. Details like wife's death, bag of books, and brother's insanity are quite intimate details for a stranger to know about. Okay? The man was right about everything except the fact that Bipin Babu had been to Ranchi. Okay? The man was not making a mistake, but he spoke a deliberate lie. Bipin Babu was sure that he was not in Kanpur at the pujas in 58, and he stayed at his friend Haridas Bakshi's place. Bipin Babu just needed to write to Haridas to clear the matter, but he suddenly remembered that he couldn't because he had moved to Japan a few weeks ago with his wife, and Bipin Babu did not have his new address. Okay? But there was the need for proof. He himself was fully aware that he had not been to Ranchi, and that was that. Okay? So what happened here? Then Bipin Babu thought that there was no need for proof because he was quite sure that he had never been to Ranchi and there was no doubt about it. The river breeze was bracing, and yet a slight discomfort lingered in Bipin Babu's mind. Around Hastings, Bipin Babu decided to roll up his trousers and take a look at his right knee. There was a mark of an old inch-long cut. It was impossible to tell when the injury had occurred. So here, bracing means stimulating, lingered means spending a lot of time over something that will be thinking very deeply. Hastings means rapidity of action or motion. Okay, Hastings means very quickly. What happened here? The breeze along the river was comforting with the Bipin Babu's mind. It was still not at peace, hence he was not comfortable with his thought. Amidst everything, he decided to roll up his trousers to see if his right knee has a mark. He did find an inch long cut, but it was nearly impossible to infer the date of injury. Okay? So what happened? He started to roll up his trouser and look for the pain or the wound that had occurred, whether the strange person Parimal Ghosh is really talking the truth. So in order to have a clear idea about what had happened, he started to look for his right knee, and there was a mark of injury. Okay, till now we have discussed the conversation between the Parimal Ghosh and the Bipin Babu. Bipin Babu came to nearby the car where he has parked and told his driver Sitaram to move on. While traveling, he had a deep thought in his mind whether the strange person was talking truth or not. So he rolled up his pant and started looking for the pain or the wound that he had before. Okay. We'll wind up the class here. We'll have the discussion on the further part of the lesson in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.